Hey, what's going on, guys? It's One Maximum RPM coming at you with another video today. And in this video, we're going to be doing Jawjammer Jackal versus Demon Achilles. But before we get into this battle, I want to have a quick little chat about Jackal. Some people were really confused when I made the first Jackal because, he uses mostly Takara and Hasbro parts. He uses the Judgment Layer, the turn frame. I mean, people really don't talk about combos that much when it comes to 3D printed bays as far as originality, but a lot of people are confused why I use Judgment. It will make sense in the skits. And also, I do plan on actually upgrading the GT Jackal at some point. So this is Jawjammer. And the combo is temporary right now. The driver's definitely going to change. So this is it in its low mode, or it's destable, or it's essentially an attack mode. Combo currently is Sting Absorb, and we're going to be battling it against a Takara Tomy Z Achilles. On this channel, it's known as Demon Achilles. 11 Extend Plus. This is a custom Extend Plus that I made. Let's get right into it. First to 7. Jackal is a switch frame bay. Just because I'm curious. If Jackal goes down, I'm not going to count it. Alright. Little ambitious about the whole stamina game on Jackal. Got a lot of low down weight, which is super good for defense. Right now, he's in his more vulnerable mode. Score is 2-0. But Achilles in attack mode now. God, that's loud. One was a snipe. God, I hate Extend Plus sometimes. We're going in defense mode because apparently that's the only thing he'll work with. That's stamina. And there's Al. An issue with switch frame bays, or at least all of mine. Insta figured it out. Chad figured it out. Dang it. There we go. Alright, so the score is 3-0. I'm going to switch Jackal's combo. Or not combo, but mode. So we're going to put him in high mode now. Or essentially destabilization mode or defense mode. Whatever you want to call it. The reason that this is his defense mode is because now his layer key is more protected, and it changes the weight balance of him. Not many switch frame bays actually do that. The whole flippable layer. I can only think of two other than Jackal, and that's my Wolg and Insta's Backlash. I'm trying to think. Please, if anyone can think of other switch frame bays that have that flipping gimmick, please feel free to leave them down in the comment section below. Because I'm drawing a blank. Some people are probably wondering why I'm using Achilles. Because Achilles hits really hard, and he's got good burst resistance. Jackal's a lot more defensive than I originally intended. He is a balance type, though. Oh, Sir Scooty would be proud. We need something with more attack. Okay, we're gonna do Judgment versus Jawjammer. A little bit of a bonus match. So I'm going to put Jawjammer back into low mode. Interesting. One to zero. Judgment definitely lands the hard hits that he needs to, but I think because of the low mode, I think it's actually countering it pretty well. Not doing bad. Yeah, it's the low mode. I don't know if you guys can see it on camera, but Judgment landed three hits in a row, and it lifted the driver off the ground every time. So that's like 2-0. I'm going to switch it into high mode, because I want to see if we can knock it out. So the weird thing is, when I put it in high mode, it gets easier to knock out. It makes them harder to burst, but easier to knock out. So it's like a double-edged sword. But that's a good thing. That way he's not too overpowered. See, he moves around a lot easier now. And it's because his balance is way different. Now his balance is all up high. Like a normal bay. His weight is up real high. But when he's in the other mode, his weight is so low down. He's really stable. Like I said, he's got a lot of defense. So, Jackal is actually a balance type. And I just don't have the driver that I want. I want to use Zone X. That's the one where it's free spinning, correct? I think so. Maybe that's the Z chip. It's either the X chip or the Z chip. I forget. But the reason I want to use that combo is because, one, it's going to have really good life after death. I'm going to have to switch Jackal's disc because this thing is tearing my sting apart. Okay, so... Ooh! Ooh! Oh, that's interesting. Jackal's new disc might be Vanguard. But the reason that I wanted Exceed, or sorry, Zone, is because, it's still got attack, it'll have a lot of stamina with that chip, and it'll have a really good defense, which is the main thing I'm going for, is for Jackal to have a lot of defense and still good attack, and the attack's gonna come from his weight. So I stuck Vanguard on it. Let's do a real quick test match. It's definitely lighter. That was a super good hit by Judgment. Noticing a large lack in stamina. He's definitely a lot lighter. However, I don't know. Okay, this is good. This is good. And a lot of people might be confused on why I'm saying that. And Jackal lost a tooth. That's no big deal. It's a switch frame bay. A lot of people complain about switch frame bays. About them being too hard to burst. And, a lot of us have a rule, where the layer key needs to be exposed and can be made contact with. And when it's in its low mode, it's designed so it can be hit. All of my switch frame bays are. The only one that isn't is Banshee, and that's, it can be hit, it's just too round to do anything with. That is an issue that I am working on. I just haven't had the time to fix it. That and Banshee really doesn't have a whole lot of stamina, so I really don't see a reason to fix his layer key at the moment. I definitely will, just not at the moment. So, its high mode is made for bays that can burst it. The high mode is basically designed for bays that are strong enough to actually burst jackal, but it's not a main mode. It's... Switch ramp system kind of does that sometimes. High mode wasn't actually designed for all-time use. It's more of it's a backup. It's there if I need it. That's a snipe shot. Its low mode was, or its high mode, sorry, was designed for, pretty much, it's like, if I get burst, it's like, alright, we'll switch to high mode now, because he's clearly a strong enough bay to burst it. I'm kind of liking it on Vanguard, because no one uses Vanguard too, which makes Jackal special now. So, alright guys, that is going to be about it. And some people are curious as to how Jackal works. So it hides inside of its switch frame here. When I remove the layer key, Vanguard tapers downward. And what it does is it sits up inside the disc. And goes in. So the switch frame system is really simple. It's basically just the frame on a Beyblade that goes over the layer. That's all the switch frame really is. It's a pretty simple system, but it's fantastic. It works amazing. It's designed by Quake and Bacon. Fantastic creator. Check him out. So yeah, that's about it, guys. That's the new Jackal in action. And I'd say it's a pretty good upgrade. Definitely have some work to do, though. Also, since this print failed so bad, I want to show you guys something. I was trying something. You guys can take a guess at what this is going to be. I know no one's going to get it. And if they do, I'm going to be incredibly impressed. Alright guys, that's about it. Please leave a like, comment, and subscribe. Turn on the bell notification so you get all of my videos because I upload daily. And as always, I hope that this video makes your day just a little bit better. Live life to the max and stay awesome.